Hi, I'm Sunks. I'm one of the co-founders of Recall. Welcome. What you're looking at right now is my personal Recall knowledge base, and I'm using Recall for a bunch of different things. All of my favorite movies, recipes, research on health and longevity, and also just as my own personal note taker. Now you can access your own via the web app, the beta mobile app, but one of the best ways is with the Recall browser extension. With the browser extension, you have access to Recall on any page you browse to. You can summarize it, chat with it, take your own notes, but it also gives you access to our newest feature, augmented browsing. Now, as you browse, you see certain connections on the page highlight, and these are things already saved in your Recall knowledge base, so it really helps you unlock connections in your knowledge that you otherwise might have missed. Let's get started by adding content into Recall. If you're in the web app or the mobile app, click the Create Card button and you can just paste in the URL of any online content, search Wikipedia, upload your PDFs, import your bookmarks, or even just create your own notes. A great tip is that if you're on mobile, you can just share content directly with the Recall app. But the best way to get content into Recall is with the Recall browser extension. So you're gonna wanna add the extension, you'll find a link to it within the app, pin it, browse to content that you want to save into Recall, click the extension, and you can see in just a few seconds, you get a really high quality summary. You can skip to particular parts in the video that you're interested in. You can highlight and take your own notes. You can even chat with it. Now, everything you do with the extension automatically syncs with your Recall knowledge base. Now, once it's saved into Recall, it creates what we call a Recall card. You can see that it's automatically categorized. You can also add your own categories or nest them using the /sign. On the left-hand side, what you see is the reader. Now, the reader is the full content. In this case, it's the transcript. But we also save the full article, the full PDF, whatever it is that you save into Recall. You can also collapse the reader if you don't want to see it side by side. But I like it because I have my original content and then I have my summary. Now, going back into the chat, you can actually switch between a concise summary or detailed summary. This is configured in your settings, the default action, so do take a look. We can see this is about the truth about creatine. So let's find out what is the truth. Okay, and you can see really quickly, you get straight to the point on what the benefits of creatine are, and I can also just add this back to my notebook. So just as a reminder, notebook is where I have my summary from earlier, I also have my chat, and everything here is fully editable, so you can really customize it and make it your own. The next thing I want to show you are connections. So anything you save into Recall, we extract keywords from it and connect it if that keyword was in any other cards you've saved into Recall. I can see that sleep was mentioned in this video, and I can see I have 10 other pieces of content that mention sleep. You can also see a visual representation of this by using the graph view and then filtering the graph by going into a particular area of interest on the left-hand side panel. So this, for example, is my heat exposure graph, and I can sort of look at what is at the center connecting all of my notes. But the really powerful way that these connections unfold is with augmented browsing. So when you have augmented browsing on, you'll also see that you have a widget. This widget shows you how many connections you found in this page. So on this protocol for sleep, I have 14 things that are connected to things that I've saved within my Recall knowledge base. It's also great because you have a shortcut to any actions that you want to take. But specifically focusing on these connections, I can see the word glycine is mentioned. And I'm like, oh, this looks familiar. I think I've seen it before. And I have. So opening it up, I can see that glycine was mentioned in a perplexity search that I had saved on the supplements that Brian Johnson takes, and I can see exactly where glycine was mentioned and how much he takes. Coming back to the Recall card, I wanted to end off with the quiz. Now, anything you save into Recall, you can go to the quiz tab, click generate questions, and it will automatically create a quiz for you. Now, anything that you run a quiz on gets added to a slightly bigger feature called the Recall Review. Now, this uses active recall and spaced repetition to create a schedule tailored to your learning curve. The more I get things correct, the less I see it. The more I get things wrong, the more I see it. So it's really built to enhance your long-term memory. That's it for this tutorial. I highly recommend that you check out the settings so you can see all the things that you can customize within your Recall knowledge base. Welcome, and please reach out with feedback, ideas, or questions.